Sagittarian peeps, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Amphor Cancer Moons Tarot, and I'm coming at you guys with your mid-October 2021 tarot reading. I hope you guys are well, and if so, let me know down in the comments down below. As always, readings here are general, so if they do resonate to you guys, that's awesome, and if not, it's not your message. And if you guys want to check out my official social medias, all that information is going to be linked down in the description box below. So Sagittarius, welcome on into mid-October, guys, and let's have a look here and see what we got going on, starting off with the current energy for Sagittarius. Let's see what current energies are coming through here for your second half of the month. What current energies do we got coming through for Sagittarius? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus throughout their mid-October 2021. What current energies are coming through here for Team Saggy? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus throughout their mid-October 2021. What do we got? Let's have a look, okay? We got here the Six of Wands, we got here the Knight of Wands, and then we also have here the Two of Wands. So, I'm definitely feeling a little bit of confusion of, like, which path to pick, like, what is the right direction for me to go into? Because you obviously want to be in a direction of success, right? You obviously want to go towards somewhere that's successful, but the journey to get there, what's going to be the right path? We got here that Two of Wands. So I feel like you're trying to get yourself figured out here, Sag, in the second half of October. Maybe right now you're not sure where you want your career to take you. Maybe you're not sure where you want love to take you. Maybe you're not sure in general with your own personal development of like where you want to grow and what certain areas you want to grow in. So I do feel like this energy of feeling a little lost. But you know what though? There's nothing wrong with being lost. There's actually been a couple moments in my life where I have been lost and I found the remedy. The best remedy that you can do when you feel lost is let yourself be found, you know? And by doing that, that just means going with the flow, having different experiences, trying new things, doing new shit, and kind of just letting loose, you know? Don't put so much pressure on yourself to have it all figured out, you know? I think a lot of people, especially in my age bracket, I'm 22, so I'm in my 20s, and I think a lot of people within my age bracket put so much pressure on themselves to try to figure out what the hell they want to do with their lives and what they want to do for the rest of their lives. And I just don't think it's that simple. You know, you can be 50 years old and so on and so forth and still not have it all figured out. And that's still fucking okay. I think the greatest thing about life is that life is filled with experiences and experiences for us to have. And if we're always worried of wondering what we're supposed to do, we're never going to figure out what we want to do, right? So have some fucking experiences here, Sagittarius, in the second half of your October. Don't worry about having to have it all figured out, you know? It's only going to put you in an anxious place. It's only going to put you in a stressed out place, a worried place, and you don't want to be there. All right? So instead, King of Wands, take some action here this month. And when I say take action to just go with the flow. Whatever kind of comes your way, take it and roll with it. See what happens, all right? All right, let's start clarifying some cards real quick. I want to clarify this Two of Wands. What is the confusion here that's kind of making Sagittarian lost? And what area of their life do they necessarily feel lost? We have here the Six of Cups, and then behind the Six of Cups, we have the Ace of Swords. So I love when cards come out like this, because it talks about the flip side of situations. So on one side here, Sagittarius, you want to be in a very much so clarity type of energy. You want to know everything, you want to have it all figured out, so that you can plan your future accordingly, and that you can live your life based upon your plan. But when you take a look at the Six of Cups is a card that can represent the past, but it also could be a card of acceptance. So I think you guys are on the brink of accepting that I just don't know what I want to do with my life versus no, I need to have it all figured out. I would go for the Six of Cups. Just accept that you don't really know where you want your life to go right now. It's totally okay that you don't know that information. It's totally okay that you don't have all the answers, figured out, because not everybody does. You know, some people find that out later in life. Some people find it out early in life. Some people don't find it out at all. They just keep on going with the flow and living life because I don't think anybody's ever going to have it totally figured out, you know? So anyways, guys, you know, with that Two of Wands showing up, you could feel lost in any area of your life. Remember, it's a general reading, so maybe some of you feel lost in your love lives. Other of you could feel lost in your career. You could feel lost in what you're supposed to do with yourself, right? But whatever it is you feel lost in, you know, the more you worry about having to have this perfect plan and have it all figured out, the more you're just going to drain yourself, you're going to burn yourself out, and you're not going to enjoy your life experience. Remember, you incarnated here to learn, to grow, to live, to laugh, to love, and to have as many experiences as possible. So just live your life, man, all right? I know I sound like a hippie, but just live your life, man. You know, that's gonna be the motto for the second half of October here. Let's go ahead and clarify this Knight of Wands. Why is the Knight of Wands showing up over here? And what do we got? We got the Seven of Swords. Interesting. Yeah, it's that pressure, guys. I'm feeling pressure with the Seven of Swords. It's like, I feel so pressured to have everything figured out. I feel pressured to know what my job is supposed to be, to know what my career is supposed to be. I feel pressured to settle down and find my soulmate and have a family. I feel pressured to just know what my life is supposed to be and devote my life to my life's mission. It's like, so much fucking pressure, you know? And that pressure is only going to consume you, you know? Do you want to risk losing your soul in the process of having life all figured out? You never want to lose your soul in anything, guys, you know? In a way, many people can look at life in many different ways, you know? Some, like, for example, I look at life as just experiences. Other people look at life as pointless. It's like, we're on a fucking floating rock, you know? It is what it is. Do whatever the fuck you want. I look at it as, have as many experiences as you want. Other people are like, well, I was born or destined to do something, you know? At the end of the day, what sits well with you? For me, I think we all have an opportunity here to just figure out what we like. I don't think we have to, you know, really get involved in the pressure. You know, the pressure society puts on us, the pressure our family puts on us, the pressure our friends put on us, the pressure our environment puts on us. I don't think we need to succumb to that pressure to make something of ourselves. I think that we should just say, hey, I know who I am, and if I don't have it all figured out yet, that's okay. I'm going to do what's enjoyable. All right? And lastly, let's clarify the Six of Wands. I'm not sure if we already clarified it, but I'm going to clarify it anyways. Let's clarify the Six of Wands. And for the Six of Wands, we have the Nine of Wands. So I think that you just don't want to end up being a failure, Sagittarius, okay? Failure is something that you do not want to experience. You want to be the Six of Wands. You want to have success in whatever direction your life goes into. For some of you, I'm hearing you may have a lot of pressure to fail. So you may have a lot of pressure on you in regards to having to succeed. You might come from a family that is filled with expectations and is constantly wanting you to thrive and succeed. And, you know, if you don't meet their expectations, they're going to, you know, put their negativity on you or their judgment on you, right? Remember, guys, like, even if it's family, dude, your life is your life. Don't let other people set up expectations for your life. Disappoint their expectations beyond belief, because you should be only fulfilling your expectations of what you expect from yourself, you know? Don't try to keep up with anybody else's, because at the end of the day, that's only going to be somebody else running the show of your own life. Meanwhile, you're the star of your own life, okay? All right, guys, I feel like we talked a lot about this so far. Let's go ahead and get on into the rest of the reading. So I want to see what's coming in here for Sagittarius, moving throughout their second half of October. What's going to be coming in here for Sagittarius? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus throughout mid-October 2021. We got here the Four of Swords, we got here the Five of Pentacles, we got here the Hermit, and we got here the Eight of Pentacles. So, I definitely see a lot of you guys go in Hermit mode. You know, Five of Pentacles is that energy where it's like, I feel like I have nothing to my name right now. I don't know where the hell things are going. You got here the Hermit card. It's like, I don't really want to talk to anybody. I don't really want to let anybody know what's going on with me, because I don't want people to see that I'm living my life without a plan. So, Eight of Pentacles jumps out here too. Eight of Pentacles is kind of referring to you guys saying, I'm working on my life, I'm trying to figure things out. But throughout this whole process, you're essentially stressing yourself out, guys. Alright? Alright. So that's what's coming in for you. I mean, I feel like moving throughout the rest of mid-October, what's coming in is just a lot more stress. What's coming in is just a lot more of you guys kind of avoiding people because you're scared to say, hey, I'm a little lost in my life right now. I don't know what's going on. Like, for example, if a friend says, hey, how's it going? You know, how's the job search going? Or how's your career going? You're like, oh, everything's perfect. Everything's fine. And it's like, no, you know, you're not being honest. You're not sitting there saying, actually, I don't really know where things are going. I'm kind of just feeling it out, you know? There's no shame in that, guys. So I don't want anybody here to ever feel shame if you don't have it all figured out, because not everybody does. And even the people who seem that they do still don't have all the shit figured out in their lives, okay? All right, Sagittarius. Let's move forward. Let's see if there's any dire or important messages that Sagittarius needs to hear stepping into the second half of their October. Are there any dire or important messages that Sag needs to hear throughout the second half of their October 2021? We got here the Strength card, okay? Don't be afraid to pull back, King of Cups. And we got here the Ten of Swords. Sagittarius, Don't be afraid to pull back. Don't be afraid to take care of yourself and your mental health and yourself in general over the needs, wants, and desires of other people. Expectations is coming back up again here with these three cards jumping out. Don't be afraid to disappoint other people, because guess what? As long as you don't disappoint yourself, you're doing the right thing. With the King of Cups showing up here too, make sure that your emotions are more considered than the emotions of others. For example, let's say that you have a parent who wants you to be a doctor, but at the end of the day, you want to be a physicist. Be a fucking physicist. Screw being the doctor. Just because your family wants you to do it doesn't make it right. Just because your family wants you to do it doesn't mean they're correct. So, like, really continue to take your feelings and emotions into account and make sure that you're going based upon what you feel is right for you, all right? Anything else that tries to come in your way, any other person that tries to stop you from doing what you want to do, remove yourself from that situation, all right? So that's one dire and important message. Is there any other dire or important messages that Sag needs to hear stepping into the second half of October? And we got here the Wheel of Fortune. Don't be afraid to let your life change. So if there's any sort of drastic changes coming in here for you, Sag, or if you're in the place where you want to make a drastic change that requires a drastic leap of faith, don't be afraid to do that either. For example, let's say that you work in the tech business and you want to make a giant leap into the restaurant business. Don't be afraid to go ahead and take that leap of faith. Make sure you do your research. Make sure you learn about the business. Obviously, bring some practicality into it, but don't be afraid to make that leap. If you're tired of working for tech and you want to go in there and start managing some restaurants, go for it, man. Maybe food is something you're very passionate about and you want to put a smile on a customer's face. You want somebody to have a great dining experience, you know? If that's something you're interested in, don't be afraid to make the switch, you know? So if there's any sort of massive changes that are going to require you guys to go through in mid-October, if you're a little nervous about that, take the leap of faith anyways. Just do it in a logical way. Do it in a very practical way to where you kind of cover your bases. For example, if you're switching from one career to another, learn about the next kind of career that you're jumping into. Really give yourself time to study it and to learn it, right? So don't be afraid there. That's another important message coming through. Even if something is a giant leap of faith for you, take it anyways. You never know where it's going to take you, you know? All right, guys. What else should we see here? So we took a look at your overall current energies. We clarified those. We took a look at where what's coming in for you. Let's see where things are going. Where are things going here for Sag in the second half of their October, based upon all the energies we covered currently? Where are things going to be going for Sagittarius? We got here the Queen of Swords. All right, moving forward from that, we got here the Lovers, we got here the Eight of Swords, and we got here the Temperance card. I feel like inevitably, Sag, you know, this month is going to be that month where you kind of have your breaking point and say, I'm so tired of having to please other people. I'm so tired of trying to meet other people's expectations. I'm so fucking tired of trying to figure out what the hell I'm supposed to do, to the point where it's like, I give up. Queen of Swords, Eight of Swords. I'm cutting out these thoughts of constantly overthinking of where I'm supposed to be. Am I doing the right thing for myself? Am I living my life the way it's supposed to be? I'm done stressing myself out. Instead, I'm now going to start messing around with what it is I'm connected to. So keep in mind, the Lovers card here does not have to represent love. In this situation, I view it as something you feel very connected to. So you're in a space where it's like, I'm going to start going after what it is I'm very connected to right now, what it is that really resonates with me. And with the Temperance card showing up here, you're going to see how you're not losing your soul in the process anymore. You're going to see that your soul is now starting to become happy. You're no longer drained trying to meet other people's expectations. You're no longer drained trying to have everything figured out for you inside your life. You're just saying, fuck it, man. I'm going with the flow and seeing where life takes me. And that feels so much better for me on a beautiful physical and mental aspect. It feels 10 times better for me. This feels like the right thing to do. And that's what I was trying to tell you guys all along. You know, going with the flow is what's really going to help you guys in mid-October. You know, don't succumb to other people's expectations. Don't succumb to like the societal pressure that tells you you need to have it all figured out. You don't, you know what I'm saying? Just go with the flow in your life, and wherever the hell your life takes you, enjoy it, you know? That's what I got here for you, man. That's what I got, Sag. Go with the flow, man. Take life one day at a time and see where it goes. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that, okay? As for the overall outcome for my Saggies, throughout their mid-October 2021, what's going to be their overall outcome? And we got here the Six of Swords. Either way, you're still going to move to somewhere. Either way, you're still going to align to where you're supposed to be in the end. One of the biggest reasons why I always tell people, if you feel lost, just do whatever you want and eventually you'll be found, is because it is inevitable that you will fall into alignment with where you're supposed to be. That's how the universe works. Eventually and inevitably, we will always align to where we're supposed to be. So if you don't know where your career is going right now, go try some new jobs. If you don't know where your love life is going right now, go date some people or take some people out on dates. Get to know somebody. If you don't know where your life in general is going, go do something you've never done before. Go hiking. Go, you know, fucking on a vacation to Bora Bora. Go somewhere you've never been before, okay? Do something new in your life, because that actually may be the next stepping stone that guided you exactly to where you need to be, you know? For example, before I started doing tarot here on YouTube, I was working at a drugstore, you know, stocking shelves, you know, unloading trucks, you know, shit like that. And it was fun. It was cool. But at the end of the day, like, I wanted to do something different. And then I remember watching my first tarot reading and it resonated so hard. And I said, yo, I want to buy a pack of tarot cards. Then I bought a pack of tarot cards and I flowed with it. And I made videos on YouTube. And then a couple months later, I quit my job. And then I started doing YouTube full time, because it was just one of those situations where it's like, I went with the flow. I knew I wasn't going to work at that drugstore forever, but I went with the flow. And it brought me here. So the more you flow with the universe, the more you end up stepping into alignment with where you're supposed to be. All right, Sagittarius. So guys, I love you all so much. I'm being called to remind you once again, don't be afraid to make drastic change, okay? Do not be scared to make drastic change. Do it in a practical way. Make sure you learn about what it is that you're jumping from one situation to another. Make sure that you do it in a practical way and you'll be okay. All right? All right, Sag, I love you. Enjoy the rest of October, everybody, and I will catch you all in November. Take care, Sagittarian, and have yourselves a good one. Peace.